Centenary's Care Ministry and Stephen Ministry works with those in our congregation who can no longer attend church. They take communion and comfort to homebound members of our congregation. Here's a little story from longtime Centenary member Betty Browers.
Betty, since we've been coming to visit you here at Brook Ridge, I have learned so much about you and how much you've been involved in Centenary. What are some of the things that you miss about being able to go to church on Sunday mornings?
Well, of course I miss the being with the people, yeah, and seeing the people that I don't ever see anymore. Mm-hmm. And because I had a lot of good friends in the church. And a lot of them are like me. They've either passed away or they don't go. Mm-hmm. I'm sure, you know, that there's a lot of them.
And actually some of them are here.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Well, what's some of your memories of Centenary?
We had, I missed the United Methodist Women because we had such a big group and we were all really friendly, and it was a really good group of people.
Mm-hmm. Was it Sunday school? You told me that you had 65
uh-huh.
or so,
yes,
in Sunday school.
Yes, we had 65.
And what was the name of that group?
Crusaders.
Crusaders.
Yeah. Well, I thought the Crusaders class, that we had so much fun. Mm-hmm. When we had parties, we had so much fun. And Ella Mackey could make that piano practically jump off the floor, and she never ever had a book. She couldn't even read music. And it always, after we ate, it was always, okay, Ella, get the piano, you know. And we'd sit around the piano and sing, and I miss those people, you know. And Betty Edmondson, she comes over every week and gets me and takes me to Walmart, and a lot of times we go to Brahms and get ice cream, and if I need to go someplace else, she'll take me.
We try to, on Sunday that we have communion at church, the sacraments are blessed there, and we take those straight from the altar and bring those directly to you all. And so that, I hope, makes you feel like you're part of that service mm-hmm. on that Sunday morning. Mm-hmm. Is that something that you've enjoyed having?
Yes, that's
okay. So after church on Sundays, we kind of make the rounds. Mm-hmm. Billy John Lee, Betty Brown.
Oh, is she
know
over
her?
There?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, and then we have, there's four of us here. Well, you bring them to Jean too, don't you?
Uh-huh.
So that's five.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Did I miss anybody?
No. Mm-hmm. We have several centenarians mm-hmm. out here that we bring communion to. It makes it kind of nice that everybody's in uh-huh. one place.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I noticed your pictures of you and Howard up there
yeah,
on the wall.
Those were ones they took when they used to take them at
church
the church.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
This was one that was taken before we were married, of Howard. This one was taken, well, both of them were before we were married.
I noticed where even you were part of a group called the Catherine Harper Club,
mm-hmm.
and you guys had made dresses for young girls.
Mm-hmm. We made a lot of things.
So I think your message is important.
Well, I'm glad. I hope I've done something good.
You have. And to Judy Stiles and I, who have visited you, you've been a real blessing to us.
Well, I keep telling everybody, there's something I haven't done. There's something that I am supposed to do that I haven't done. And he's leaving me here till I do it, mm-hmm. but I don't know what it is. Mm-hmm. And that's, I do, I feel that way. I feel like there's something that I haven't done.
I want to thank you for sharing with us today, Betty.
Well,
I really appreciate it.
There are so many stories around Centenary. What's your story?